नित्यानन्दं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वते साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि. With the divine grace and unending compassion of Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Nityananda Paramashivam, we welcome each and one of you with our love and respect. We welcome every one of you to Kailasa's Nityananda TV, the official TV programming of Sri Kailasa, the greatest and only Hindu nation, revived by Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Nityananda Paramashivam. Today is the most auspicious day of Deepavali, and we wish all our viewers joining us, you and your family, a very happy Deepavali. And we want to convey and once again remember the message from Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Nityananda Paramashivam, on the most auspicious occasion of Deepavali. Light the powerful cognitions constantly in your life and make sure you're courageous to go behind and follow the powerful cognitions ferociously. Light the powerful cognitions constantly in your life and make sure you are courageous to go behind, follow the powerful cognitions ferociously. That was the message from the Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Paramashivam, to all living Hindus, practicing Hindus worldwide, to all of humanity, on the most auspicious occasion of Deepavali this year, 2020. We have been discussing various topics in this segment. And I have with us Sri Nitya Sundareshwarananda Maharaj, who has been sharing with us his insights as well on various topics that make a direct impact on the lives, the lifestyle, the environment, the quality of life of living and practicing Hindus worldwide. Nityananda Maharaj, and a very happy Deepavali to you.
Thank you very much, Swami. Nityanam, everybody. And I once again would like to wish every one of you on this auspicious day of Deepavali and the beautiful morning of Nitya Satsang with various celebrations that are coming up. Early in the morning, we had the Maheshwara Puja, and the entire day today is filled with various celebrations, festivals, and rituals. And it's a power-packed day, and the life here at Kailasa, the lifestyle itself is a lifestyle of celebration. And in today's part of the pre-segment, officially, we are having the voting, which is Kailasa Votes, which is revived by His Divine Holiness, Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam. For the first time, He has given us this opportunity to cast our vote, where the Hindu votes matter, Hindu votes are sacred, and the first ever elections, the Hindu elections, have been in progress, and today we are coming towards the most important day of that particular election. And once again, I would like to welcome and invite every one of you to go over to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 to go and cast your vote at for vegetarianism or non-vegetarianism, as that's what we've been looking at over the last few weeks now. And once again, I would like to invite and welcome every one of you to become part of Sri Kailasa, which is the greatest and the only Hindu nation. Claim your free e-passport at kailasa.org/e-passport, free-e-passport. And today, we're also going to take a look at the different, a few more aspects of the meat industry and how that has the adverse effects on our lifestyle. Let us look at some statistics and data.
There is a flip side to the meat industry. There is a flip side to the choices that we make at our food table. There is a flip side to the diet that we choose. The meat industry produces massive amounts of animal waste, like urine and manure, that emit around 400 different harmful gases into the atmosphere. This is a direct impact of the choices that we make on the environment, on the entire planet itself. Some of these gases include nitrous oxide, ammonia, particulate matter, endotoxins, and hydrogen sulfide. All chemicals that are not to be present in the air that we breathe, and because of rain, they will come back into the soil that we have our food grown. And eventually we end up consuming these chemicals. And we can only imagine the effect of this on human life. Exactly how, as a vicious cycle, this is again and again coming back to us and impacting our lives. What is not seen is this vicious loop. The choice that we make, the choice that we take when we pick between a vegetarian and a non-vegetarian diet comes back to us in a very invisible manner. And that is the flip side. That should ring alarm bells for all of us. How just by supporting, just by having a non-vegetarian meal, we are contributing to poisonous chemicals back in the same food that we eat, in so many other food items, in so many other food materials. This is a vicious loop that is far hidden from us. We do not see this in the advertisements. We do not see this in the conversations, but this is the researched truth. This is the data that is available to us. If you feel this is something that has to stop, something can change and must change, and you want to do something about it, make your vote count. Log on to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 and join this conversation on Twitter. Hindu votes are sacred. Hindu votes are sacred is the hashtag that you can use and join this conversation. Tomorrow, we will be having the result of this voting, this global Hindu election. Hindu votes are sacred for vegetarian or non-vegetarian food. Last night, Jagadguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Swarupashivam, gave a clarion call for every practicing Hindu worldwide and living Hindu worldwide. Let us do the voting. If you have not voted for vegetarian or non-vegetarian, please vote. Hindu votes are sacred and Hindu votes matter. And Swamiji also mentioned, Hindu tradition is the most authentic and real democratic tradition. It is a real democratic tradition. And if you see how Swamiji has instituted this voting mechanism throughout every program, every session that he conducts, even in to that level, because Hindu votes matter. Hindu votes are sacred. So join, make your vote count. Log on to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 and jump on to the platform that Swamiji has created for all of us to ensure that our voices are not left behind. Our votes are counted. So cast your vote, make it count. And join the conversation on Twitter. Hindu votes are sacred. And tomorrow we are going to have the results of this voting. So this would be the last chance for you to make your choice. Make your vote count. Ensure that your vote is in place when the first ever global Hindu election is going to be counted. The election polls are now coming to a close. So make your vote count as soon as possible, immediately.
And yes, so looking at a few more statistics, we're also looking at ammonia, which is one of the most important ingredients which actually pollute the atmosphere. So if you look at the composition of ammonia, which is NH, at this point in time, ammonia, when it actually binds and forms a compound with oxygen, it creates nitrous oxide, which once again directly heats up the atmosphere and directly is part of the greenhouse gases and has a direct impact on the ozone layer and capturing the heat from the entire planet Earth. So this ammonia that we are looking at is actually 80%, and that comes just from the cattle farm and the animal waste, not utilizing the animal waste properly. And because even they are fed with plants that are filled with nitrate compounds that once again are needed for the increased growth or increased production of those particular crops, naturally the concentration level is so high that wherever this the animal waste gets mixed, it the land becomes infertile and becomes too acidic because of the high concentrations of the ammonia levels. Let us look at a few more statistics.
Yes, Maharaj. So here we see that beef is 34 times more polluting to our climate than legumes like beans and lentils by weight. If you look at the same amount of the same weight of produce and the same weight of cattle being made into food, if you make a comparison, non-vegetarian food is 34 times more polluting. If that is not a wake-up call, I don't know what is. 34 times more polluting just by weight. And this is exactly what is at stake. We need to understand the flip side of our choice that we make at the food table. We will be polluting the climate 34 times more when we are choosing a non-vegetarian diet. We have to ask ourselves, is this the price to pay? Is this the hidden cost that can be forgotten, that can be ignored? This is our climate. And we live in this planet, and we are again and again contributing to the destruction of the air quality, the water quality, and all the other natural resources. Is this the cost? Is this the price that we are willing to pay? This cost is actually hidden from us. Knowing this now, as responsible Hindus, as living and practicing Hindus, and knowing that there is a platform, there is a vote that we can exercise, it is up to us to exercise that responsibility, to exercise the right given to us and make our vote count. Log on to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 and ensure that your votes are counted. Today is the last day to submit your votes. Tomorrow, the voting about the vegetarian and the non-vegetarian diet, the results will be published. So today is the last day, the last chance that we have to become a part of the first ever global Hindu election.
And yes, So here we have an opportunity. Once again, I would like to remind every one of you to make sure that you are becoming a part of this particular discussion by going over to the Twitter and sharing your opinion. If you have any questions, you can tweet your questions and become part of this discussion using the hashtags, hashtag Kailasa Votes, hashtag Hindu Votes, hashtag Hindu Votes are Sacred, hashtag Veg or Non-Veg. Use these hashtags and go over and join this discussion. Once again, here we have an opportunity to become an e-citizen of Sri Kailasa and register yourself and claim your free e-passport at kailasa.org/free-e-passport. Let us now look at a short video before we enter into the further segments of today's program.
Welcome all of you, the whole world, to come and celebrate, enjoy not only the enlightenment ecosystem, the beauty of how it is getting revived. Be an insider for this great revival process. If you are an insider, even for a startup company, you will understand not only the result of the company, even that being an insider is such a joy. Being an insider when it was happening is something extraordinary. So I welcome all of you to come and be part of an insider of this revival of Kailasa, the enlightenment ecosystem, sovereign order of Kailasa, Kailasa nation itself. I request and welcome, invite all of you to become e-Kailashian, get your free e-passport and make billions receive his free e-passport.
Welcome back. Here, we're discussing a very important topic. And just before that, if you're just joining us, we would like to wish every one of you a very happy Deepavali. And thank you for joining us on this most auspicious occasion for Hindus worldwide. We have been looking at the discussion about a vegetarian and a non-vegetarian diet for living and practicing Hindus worldwide. And the impact of that choice that we make in various walks of our life, the life around us, the environment around us, the natural resources, the planet, the life of the planet, the species that are already getting extinct, and directly the health impact. So many various data points that we have delivered. Hinduism believes in uncompromisingly sharing data, sharing the truth, whether it is the greatest cosmic truths or it is the truth about what is happening right in front of us. Uncompromisingly sharing the truth is the essential fiber, essential framework of every living and practicing Hindu. Here, as we can see, the Science magazine has given a researched article, and they say meat eaters may speed worldwide species extinction as species-rich habitats are being converted to pasture and feed crops as the human appetite for meat grows. And they have a projection. Science magazine has come up with this projection that by 2050, given current trends, these countries will likely increase the lands used for livestock production by 30 to 50%. If you can imagine that 30 to 50% increase in destruction of the species rich habitat happens, how many more species will go extinct? How many more worldwide species will just simply disappear from the planet Earth? Our choices make a mark in how the planet changes. The footprint of every life on the planet changes. Once again, we are joined by Srinithi Sundareshwarananda Maharaj and Srinithi Mangalananda Maharaj, who will continue and share more data and share more information about this topic that we have been discussing. Nityananda Maharaj.
Yes, thank you very much, Swami. Nityananda, everybody. Welcome back once again. And as Tejas Swami was sharing with every one of us, with the current statistics that we're looking at, it is not too far. 2050 is just a few years away from now. And we also need to know that this data is based on the current increase of our population. But the population is increasing exponentially, which means that the 2050 is not going to take that long, and we are going to face these situations in just a decade or so. And literally, we are going to be spending more land on livestock production rather than on agriculture itself. Every one of us have the power to change this. Every one of us, our voice matters. And I request every one of you to take this opportunity to go over to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 to cast your vote for vegetarianism versus non-vegetarianism. The first ever Hindu elections that His Divine Holiness Jagat Guru Mahasannidhanam Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam has provided for every one of our practicing Hindus, irrespective of your birth, irrespective of your place, irrespective of from where you are and your background, but for all practicing Hindus all across the globe to have their voices count. So make sure that you're part of it, and also receive your free e-passport to join and become part of this great revival at kailasa.org/free-e-passport. I now welcome Mangala Maharaj to take us through a few more details and statistics on the same.
Nityananda, thank you, Maharaj. So yes, moving on to the next slide now. Meat eaters may speed worldwide species extinction as species-rich habitats are being converted to pasture and feed crops as the human appetite for meat swells. By 2050, given current trends, these countries will likely increase the lands used for livestock production by 30% to 50%. Some 3 million square kilometers, the researchers estimate. So the article presented by the Science magazine, you can see how, as we've been discussing continuously over the past couple of days, where the consumeristic lifestyle is affecting our current resources, our current habitats, and it is destroying not only the world but humanity as well. Not only is it causing problems for people in the form of obesity, in the form of different types of cancer, but these will also affect our next generation and our posterity as well.
Yes, and adding to that, so these ideologies and these lifestyle practices that is currently being followed will have a major negative impact on the biodiversity, and many species will be lost. As you can see on the slides, it is not that I'm eating cow, I'm not eating any other living organism, I'm not eating any other like endangered species, such as koalas, like you can see. But the ideology is that because you are consuming something else, to produce more of that, you are clearing off the biodiversity, the ecosystems that sustain the living of these indigenous creatures all across. And that has the direct say why the extinction is going to be the direct impact of meat eating industry. By revealing where most of the flora and fauna will disappear as lands are converted to agriculture, not for direct usage of humans, but for meat production. The study equips us with a means to quantify the cause of our dietary choices in terms of species loss. So here you're looking at how just our one in ignorant, or it, yes, for common mass, it is ignorance and the vested interest of a few people who are interested in nothing but just the economic gains and the consumeristic society. We are endangering and we are becoming a direct cause of extinction of an entire race and entire species from the planet Earth. You can stop this. So make sure that you're going over to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 and share and cast your vote on Kailasa, where your voice matters and you can take the responsibility to change this. So make sure that you're going over and sharing, and also become part of this discussion by going over to Twitter and share your opinion on the same using the hashtags, hashtag Kailasa Votes, hashtag Hindu Votes. Yes, so here we have a few more statistics and data. Here we're looking at another indigenous being or indigenous animal or an insect that actually is a very, very important part of our ecosystem that is facing a huge threat. Let's take a look at that. And we have Mangala Maraj, who will share a little more insight on the same.
Nityanandam, yes, so as you can see in the slide, the extinction of bees and other pollinating animals would pose a huge threat to our survival. So actually this is it's pretty obvious. Everyone knows that without the bees, there's actually an article I had saw a couple some time back, where if humans disappear, how the animal and the insects and everyone else who is sharing the planet with us, how they will thrive. But if we do not have bees and we do not have these pollinating animals, then within humanity won't even last 1 week on the planet. So keeping these species alive is very important for our survival, not just spiritually and not just morally, but for our physical survival. Without bees and without these pollinating animals, we will not have our food, we will not have crops. Pretty much our whole life will be put on halt without bees to pollinate us, without bees to pollinate the crops and our plants. So, if you see in Hinduism, in the Sanatana Hindu Dharma, even now, if you can go to find a remote vision, a remote village somewhere in some part of India, you will see that all the houses, every household especially, was a self-independent, self-sufficient ecosystem, basically. From the water they needed for their household usages, for cooking, for bathing, the crops they needed for their living, for their food, the flowers they needed for their puja, everything was grown within that household. A household maintained their own ecosystem, their own resources, basically. And ultimately, one of our fundamental concepts is we should sharing should be more than our consumption. Annam bahukuravita, as it is given in our Upanishads, make rice, make food in large quantities and share with the world. So it is not only just self-sufficient as in creating food for ourselves and consuming it, but sharing it with others as well, doing annadhan, giving it, offering it as naivedyam, as dana to the deity in the temple. All these things were a basic part of our lifestyle. And it is because of the destruction of this lifestyle where the consumerism started setting in, where people are not held accountable for what they are consuming and not giving back to society, not giving back not just to society but to the nature and environment as well. It is because of this we have come to the state of where we will not be able to survive on our planet for another 30 years. After 30 years, this planet would not be livable anymore. If only we take action now, only if we decide to vote and bring and voice this, raise these concerns, if we raise these concerns, only then we will be able to save this planet and our future generations are going to live. The way things are going, we may not be able to live our full lives itself in this planet. So this is, if this isn't waking up, then there's pretty much nothing else will. If it's very critical, very serious situation where we don't even have another 30 more years to live on this planet. It's time to decide now to vote. You can go to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1. Please voice out your opinions and share what you feel personally about vegetarianism and non-vegetarianism by joining the conversation on Twitter with the hashtags Hindu votes are sacred and the hashtags veg or non-veg. Back to you, Maharaj.
Yes, thank you very much, Maharaj. And here we're looking at another statistic that shares about the amount of biomass that is utilized by each being. Look at the percentage of humans versus all the wild animals put together that still exist and the livestock that is produced. Just look at the ratio of what it is. Just to feed the humans, see the amount of livestock that is there. At the same time, look at what we have done to the indigenous species and to all the wild animals at the cost of our meal. It is less than 3% that is left for all these wild animals to survive. If we continue to go at this rate, then naturally we are the ones who are the direct reasons and the cause for the destruction of the entire planet Earth. In our Vedagamic civilization, as Swamiji shares, the human beings are the highest possibility. Even if the gods, even if the devas, they want liberation, they want to experience the space of Kailasa, they have to take the human birth. Where we are the most evolved species, but we have stooped down so low that we are becoming the cause of the destruction of the entire species of planet Earth. And just a group of people who pose their vested interests and market it in such a way using different terminologies that is visually appealing and that is also logically convincing with the needed research data and statistics as they want. Once they are able to convince the common mass, the ignorant society, we also follow the same. It's time that we get rid of this, break this stereotype and get out of this kind of an understanding once and for all. And for this, His Divine Holiness, Jagat Guru Maha Sannidhanam, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Parameshwam has provided us an opportunity to voice out our opinion, where our voice matters, our opinion matters, our decision matters. So make sure that you go over to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 and cast your vote for vegetarianism versus non-vegetarianism. And make sure that you also go over to kailasa.org/free-e-passport and receive your free e-passport to become part of this great revival, to become an insider of the same. Let's now look at a little more data on the same.
Yes, Nityanandam. Mass extinction of species is rapidly underway. They are calling it the sixth great mass extinction of species on Earth, with up to 200 species going extinct every day. Well, this is very, very shocking, and there are no more words literally to voice and explain what is going on here. It is so obvious and it is happening not under the cover of darkness, not see in secrecy, but it is happening in broad daylight. And the most sad part is not that all this is happening, but no one is there to even take action and to even stop all these atrocities from happening. Because everyone knows that, because people know that there's no one who's going to hold them accountable, no one who is going, because they know that they are not going to personally face any consequences. They think that they have the right to do whatever they want with something which is not up to that decision. Like literally species after species is going extinct. And this is very entirely shocking. Unfortunately, because they are not able to be held accountable, no one is holding them accountable for anything. They have taken a wild run with the whole world and with whoever we share this planet with. This, the only solution for this is to come away from the consumeristic lifestyle, for more and more people to start realizing, how the consumeristic lifestyle is slowly degrading us. And by the end of 30 years to come, we will not have a world to live in. We will not have a place where our future generations can grow up and call home. It's not too late, even now. If we still decide, if we still try, and we still have the possibility, we still have the power to bring our home, our planet, Mother Earth, back from the verge of destruction. Your voice matters. Your count matters. Please take the time, hardly a few minutes, and visit kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1 and cast your vote about vegetarianism and non-vegetarianism. And please tell, what do you feel? Voice out your opinions. What do you think is required for the world to continue to sustain itself? By joining the conversation on Twitter with the hashtag Hindu Votes Are Sacred. We will now be watching a small video about Kailasa and about vegetarianism and non-vegetarianism. Please stay tuned.
not only the enlightenment ecosystem, the beauty of how it is getting revived. Be an insider for this great revival process. If you are an insider, even for a startup company, you will understand not only the result of the company, even that being an insider is such a joy. Being an insider when it was happening is something extraordinary. So, I welcome all of you to come and be part of an insider of this revival of Kailasa, the enlightenment ecosystem. Sovereign order of Kailasa, Kailasa nation itself. I request and welcome, invite all of you to become e-Kailashian. Get your free e-passport and make billions receive this free e-passport.
Welcome back. And once again, we would like to wish every one of us, every one of you watching, if you have just joined us, a very happy Diwali, the most auspicious occasion for the most auspicious celebration for all living and practicing Hindus. Today, we're looking at the discussion between having a vegetarian diet and a non-vegetarian diet. The question we are asking today is it really meat at the market? What is being consumed? What is being sold? Is it really meat? Why is this question coming up? Because there have been so much of contamination in terms of both genetically modified meat that has been made available and the inhumane treatment of animals, which has resulted in disproportionate growth in livestock. And this is a growing science in the name of optimization, in the name of increased productivity. At the end of the day, the life has become a commodity. Life has become just simple matter, in that the cattle farm, the animals are being prepared in a most cruel way, in a most unethical way, so that they maximize the profits, they maximize the meat industry's profits. If this is a anti-life decision, this is life negative. And if you feel this should never happen on this planet, this should have never happened and it should never happen in the future as well, then join this conversation. Make your vote count at kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1. Make a choice. Your vote will change this, because Hindu votes are sacred. Hindu votes matter. We can ensure that this practice stops. We can put an end to this by making a vote at the grassroots level. So log on to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1, and you can join this conversation on Twitter using the hashtag Hindu Votes Are Sacred. Ensure that your voice is heard, your opinion is registered, and shared with more and more and more people, so that this vicious loop, this vicious cycle, and all the after effects of the choices of a vegetarian and a non-vegetarian diet are brought to light, and we become aware of this particular choice and its complete effects and after effects, the impact on our planet itself. So log on and make your vote count. kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1. Hindu votes are sacred. Yes, Maharaj.
Yes, thank you very much, Swami. So here we are looking at a classic example of what we are eating, the featherless chicken. What do you think has gone into this? What modifications have been performed on this life? Go over to the Twitter and share your opinion on the same. There was one article that came about, which is actually revealing what is being used in some of the food giants like the KFC and McDonald's, especially with respect to these specifically genetically modified chickens, where they grow without any feather, just flesh, as you can see. And all of that they have is just so much filled with hormones and chemicals that no more you are eating even what you think as meat, rather just swallowing the hormones and chemicals that are injected into those organisms. At the first level, looking at the torture and the inhumane way of handling these creatures, that is first. Second, even at your own body's health and what you are going through, what is going to be the side effect on your own body's health, you can understand what you're eating. No more you're even eating meat, rather you're just eating plastic and you're eating something so-called or displayed, portrayed as meat. No more you're eating food. You're eating food-like products that look like food. Then this becomes one of the major issues of the cardiac arrest and the various other problems related to the cardiac system, because the high levels of the chemicals that are being injected into these particular genetically modified organisms to produce more amount of flesh, that has a direct negative impact on your blood level as well and the composition of your blood. So because of which, the concentration of the salts and the other chemicals in your blood, the nitrates, such as the nitrates and phosphates, increases. And because this concentration increases, the valves that are there in your heart stop functioning, or rather shut down, and causing a cardiac arrest directly. Make sure that you are getting rid of this, and make sure that you make this aware, educate more and more people by one simple contribution of yours. Just going over to kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1, casting your vote as to whether you want the vegetarian lifestyle or you want the non-vegetarian lifestyle. And not only that, you're providing a life for these beings and these species and these creatures, you are also saving your own life, your future generation's life. So make sure that you go and cast your vote. And make sure that you also apply for the free e-passport at kailasa.org/free-e-passport to receive first-hand updates, to be part of all these great revival and work that His Divine Holiness, Jagadguru Mahasannidhanam, Bhagavan Shri Nityananda Paramashivam, is doing and building the entire Kailasa, which is the only one Hindu nation on planet Earth now. Let's look at a little more detail.
This is another image that is very painful to watch. Very disproportionately grown physical features of animals, just so that the profits can be maximized. Many of the embryos that undergo genetic engineering procedures do not survive. Genetic modification can put animals at risk of harm. For example, transgenic pigs were found to be arthritic, partially blind, and infertile when a human growth hormone was inserted into the genomes to make them grow faster. And this is the key here. There are actions being taken so that the animals can grow faster, grow in a more profitable way for the meat industry. This is probably the most life negative action that we have faced, that we are facing now in the whole planet. How just to make a profit, just to make a quick profit, life is treated in this way, in the most inhumane way. And the natural progression, how intelligently the body is constructed. The body is very intelligent. All life is very intelligent, and it has been carefully constructed, carefully put together, so that a body is an ecosystem within itself, and it is self-sustaining in that it can be self-healing. Now, if all this is altered, then the natural balance is completely thrown off. The natural balance is destroyed. So imagine that life, that being having to live with modifications it can do nothing about because somebody else messed with it, and having to survive in very adverse conditions and not having the natural intelligence to address them. For example, here we saw they are partially blind due to no mistake of that being, of that life, becoming arthritic for life, becoming infertile for life. And this is what ends up as meat in the market and eventually at our food table, at our food plate. Now, this choice becomes much more clearer as this vicious cycle becomes more and more clear. The choice whether a non-vegetarian diet or a vegetarian diet should be taken up by Hindus, that also becomes much clearer as Hindus, practicing Hindus, we are life positive. We live in accordance with the cosmic law, the natural law, and life around us, supporting life, giving life, always being life positive. And it is fundamentally against the core belief system of Hinduism to be able to do such a thing to any life, simply torture and the most inhumane treatment meted out to these animals. If you feel this has to stop, this cannot continue anymore, and if you think there has to be something to be done, and even if you think against this great meat industry with its muscle power, manpower, and probably all the things that money can buy, how can we stand against any of that impact? How can we reverse the impact created? We can do it. Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness, Bhagawan Nityananda Paramashivam, has revived the Sri Kailasa, the greatest and only Hindu nation, where the core principles, the core belief system, the fundamentals of the nation are built on the Vedagamas, revelations directly given by Paramashiva himself, which means there is one place where Hindu core beliefs and core systems, core fundamental principles are in effect, and we can raise our voice, we can cast our vote and make our opinion count, make our vote count. So log on to kailasa.org/Kailasa-voting-1 and make your vote count. If you feel this has to stop, this cannot continue anymore, and whatever has happened already has to stop, and this should never happen in the future, then cast your vote, make your choice. Your individual choice has lasting global impact. Ensure you make the vote, and ensure also that every person within your circle, every person who you are connected to, also knows this vicious cycle, this inhumane treatment, and how this cannot continue. Make sure that you share this information on all the social media platforms, including Twitter. You can use the hashtag Hindu Votes Are Sacred, and share this information with as many people as possible, to every person, in fact, on this planet. Every being on this planet has to see this information so that the right choices can be made. Yes, Maharaj.
Yes. So as Tejaswami was sharing, it's now our responsibility to go over and cast our vote for the same, and share if you want to have the non-vegetarian food to be kept as an option for Hindus to eat. Yes, regularly. B, yes, ritualistically. C, no, completely stopped. So go over to kailasa.org/voting, or you can also go to the other website, kailasa.org/kailasa-voting-1, and tweet or cast your vote for the same. It's our responsibility, and every one of our voices matter. And we, together as 2 billion Hindus, can make a change and a huge impact on the entire planet Earth. Let us now watch a video on how we can cast our vote.
It is now time for us to be in Upanishad with Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Nityananda Paramashiva. Sitting with the simple integrity that we are here, open and available to receive the revelations of Paramashiva, cognize the revelations of Paramashiva. Sitting in Padmasana as much as possible, chanting the Maha Maha Vakya, the spiritual lullaby, and the Suprapata, the wake up song to awaken Paramashiva in all of us. Let us chant the Maha Maha Vakya and become ready to be in Upanishad with Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Paramashiva.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
स्वाहा अन्नमय
ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवो
It is time, let's have, it is time, let's have super conscious breakthrough from man to Sadashiva. You have grown from amoeba to fish, fish to monkey, monkey to man. Now it is time from man to Sadashiva. I am not going to use the word man to God or man to divine. All those words are too poor. I am very clear. I do not want to dilute the goal. That is why I use the word man to Sadashiva. Sadashiva is not the God as Western religions describe. He is beyond that. God is only generator, operator, destroyer. Sadashiva does two things more. Generator, operator, destroyer, deluder, and liberator. Srishti Stiti Vinasa Throbhava Anugraha. So the very concept of God in the Western religions is poor man's version of Sadashiva. Sorry, I am not interested in hurting you, but what I am saying is truth. I am not interested in hurting you. What I am saying is truth. I am not interested in hurting anybody. I am interested in giving a breakthrough to humanity. That's my only interest. I am not interested in destroying any belief system, philosophy, theology, religion established. I am just going to raise the scale. Whoever survives, survive. I am taking the whole thing to the next level. Sanatana Hindu Dharma is capable, I should say, most powerful religious tradition which is capable of giving a superconscious breakthrough to humanity. So I have collected methods and science from the Vedas and Agamas, presenting it to all of you to give you the experience of life beyond limits. Understand? I am going to initiate you experientially to manifest extraordinary powers to make you understand super conscious breakthrough is possible, software is successful. I am not a magician and I am not interested to become one. I am neither logician nor magician. Logicians are more bogus than magicians. I am neither logician nor magician. I am neither logical nor magical.
Boy, girl, blue, pink, hunter, gatherer, gay, straight, bisexual, heterosexual. The deepest identity we carry in today's world is that of gender and its million associations. The very first need is to know yourself, not by the belief of your parents, the judgment of your teachers, the vested interests of your politicians, but as can only be revealed by an enlightened source.
In Hindu tradition, till the age of 21, all of them have been asked to be a brahmachari. Not that everyone will be successful in celibacy, but that is the time they will discover their gender. Gender is not just related to body and physical maturity. It is related to physiology, psychology, and the whole being. Exploring your identity, your gender, is 10,000 times more juicy, celebrating, than exploring the other body.
If you are feeling deeply good at, wow, I am really worthy of what I am. I am really worthy of life. I am really worthy of whatever is happening around me. When you are experiencing the love for yourself, suddenly you will experience that love for the whole. You will see that everybody, everything is worthy of what they are. You feel like blessing everybody and everything.
Who am I? Starts and ends inside your body. By whom am I? Starts and ends in cosmos. By whom? By whose will everything came to existence? Seeking the source, you can capture it by developing the subtle grooves in your brain, by evolving complete completion.
Paramashiva, experience the ultimate you. Conducted by Avatar for Hinduism, His Divine Holiness, Paramahamsa Sri Nityananda.
The body in which you are residing, which is the center for your existence or your perception of existence, evolved step by step, like cell, amoeba, growing to the level of fish. Amoeba to fish is a pure physical growth, nothing more. From fish to monkey is physical and mental, both breakthroughs together. Understand? When fish started feeling, just body alone is not enough to celebrate its existence. Life is too much, body is too little. It developed a tool called mind. And next level bodies, the mind developed more and more apps and tools, if I have to talk in the software language. More and more tools and apps started developing. And at the level of monkey, beings have felt just body and mind is not enough. Universe is too much to enjoy and celebrate. Just body and mind is too little. Then beings have started developing a new component ability to reflect consciousness. Understand? When monkey started standing with two legs, the speed of the blood flow, not the quantity, the speed of the blood flow to the brain became less. So the brain started developing very subtle grooves through which it can perceive without thinking. Understand, the first perception without thinking happened is gratitude. That is why whenever you feel gratitude, the whole brain becomes active. Gratitude is the first perception without thinking. Thought currentless experience. The first experience, thought currentless, is gratitude. Listen carefully. From amoeba, cell to fish, is pure physical growth. From fish to monkey, physical and mental growth. You will be surprised. The first mental action is pornography. The perception of sex without using the body is the source of mind. That is why mind is such a torture. Beginning itself is inauspicious. The first step is inauspicious, so inauspicious. I am not saying sex is inauspicious. I am saying thought currents about it is inauspicious. From fish to monkey, body and mind breakthrough means beyond body, something was built. Then from monkey to man, beyond body and mind, something started getting perceived. The perception which is beyond thought currents have started developing from monkey to man. That is what I call ability to reflect consciousness in the system. First time, the human beings have reached a space saturation of all different permutation combination of consciousness. Listen, let me define what I mean by consciousness. It is ability to reflect, perceive beyond body and thought currents. Even if your thought currents are switched off, your body is put to rest, you have ability to perceive your existence. That's what I call consciousness. It can be in dream state, waking state, various states, deep sleep state. Even in deep sleep state, you do continuously exist even though your body and mind is switched off. That is why when you come back, you have a consistent ability to connect with what you left. You just don't get into the delete mode. No, it's not that control delete. No. It was only a break. It was not breakdown. Your consciousness, jakrat, sapna, sushupti, turiya, turiya, adita, In Agama, it is 5 into 5, 25 states of consciousness. In Vedic tradition, God is embodiment of 5 action. Srishti, Stiti, Vinasa, Throbhava, Anugraha, creation, maintenance, rejuvenation, and Lord of delusion and liberation. Listen, from amoeba to fish, physical growth, physical breakthrough, from fish to monkey, physical and mental breakthrough. Mind means ability to perceive more than body. And from monkey to man, conscious breakthrough. When I use the word conscious here, I am using in the meaning of ability to perceive even in the absence of body and mind. That ability is only available in human body. In the human body, only that ability is developed. Ability to reflect consciousness. Sometimes you are a flat mirror, sometimes concave mirror, sometimes all kinds of mirror. The village circus shows, if you are gone, you know. You will be seeing yourself 20 upside downs. I don't know whether it is popular in Western countries. In Indian countries, all village shows it will be there. I think it is universal because everyone wants to see themselves in all crooked form. So in every village show, you will find these mirror stalls. You become mirror. Your ability to mirror consciousness happened in the physical body, human body. Listen. Only when the fish felt, I think, body alone is too little to enjoy life, breakthrough into mind started happening. When monkey felt mind alone, body mind alone is too little to experience life, the conscious breakthrough started happening. It is time. Human beings have started feeling body, mind, consciousness alone is too little to enjoy universe. Tremendous depression, boredom, tiredness, teenage suicide, drugs. Understand? In next 5 years, the biggest problem of the humanity is not going to be HIV or terrorism. No. If you think terrorism, HIV, all that is going to be a big problem, no, you are wrong. It is boredom going to be the biggest problem. Human beings are going to see every alternative. Solutions. Change language, change country, changing spouses, changing husband or wife is an old fashion. Changing your own gender is going to become new fashion. Suddenly, one fine morning you decide to change your gender is going to be new fashion. But all this also will be out of fashion within 5 years. Human beings will reach the peak of boredom in next 5 years. The biggest problem human beings are going to face is boredom, because we have reached a space where we all know body, mind, consciousness which we have is too little. We need a breakthrough. The collective seeking that we need a breakthrough answer for that collective seeking, we need a breakthrough answer for that collective seeking answer for that collective boredom, solution for that collective boredom, answer for that collective seeking is this Life Beyond Limits program. Understand, it is time, let's have super conscious breakthrough from man to Sadashiva. You have grown from amoeba to fish, fish to monkey, monkey to man. Now it is time from man to Sadashiva. I am not going to use the word man.